Folks, this is part of the broadcast where I tell you to click subscribe, okay? This is the part of the broadcast where I tell you a little bit about my personal news, about what's going on in my life. We're back. So let's do it. Let's get right to it. You know what I mean? For those of you who don't know, I was in France over the weekend. Maybe you were thinking to yourself, why the fuck is Hasan not streaming? I don't really understand why Hasan is not streaming. He almost always streams. Nothing could ever stop him from streaming. Well, there was apparently something that could stop me from streaming. I brought my fucking fat ass streaming backpack to France. I brought it with me with the hopes that I was going to be able to, stream out there. And I was wrong. Okay. I was wrong because fate had a different idea. Over the weekend, I went to TwitchCon Paris. We stayed in Port de Versailles, where there is a convention center. And the first day slash night was fine. I landed and immediately got into some action. We went out, linked up with Squeezie, the largest content creator in France, who had hit me up a week prior to me going to France. Completely kismet, completely unrelated to me going to France. He hit me up because he was coming to America, and he was like, I'm a fan of yours, I would love to link up when I'm out there. And I was like, I have no idea who this guy is, why is he so famous, what the fuck is going on? And we talked a little bit, and I was like, you know what? Let's go get some grub. You know, take us out to a nice place. I asked around about him, and everyone in France was like, oh my god, I love him. Like they were freaking out. So first night we went out to dinner. It was wonderful. Okay, him and his friends, and it was a decadent experience. I talk extensively about that on our latest episode of Fear End that we shot from his studio. You went to see the catacombs while you were in Paris? No, I didn't see anything. I'll tell you why. First of all, I was in Paris for TwitchCon, so I had a lot of work to do, and I thought maybe I'll stream when I'm not actually working, and I was wrong. I couldn't do any of those things. You want to know why? Because the first day, I got into a fucking freak golf cart accident when they were, I love motherfuckers going, work. It, like, even if you are to claim Twitch streaming is not work, which it's not, right? It's a lot of fun. This is the one aspect of it that is quite literally work. You know what I mean? You have to go and do a bunch of stuff that I normally wouldn't do, but it's in my contract that I have to do it. But yeah, there is a golf cart that like transports all the content creators from one area to like where they're supposed to be going. And this dude was going crazy mode. He was driving like a madman. And I thought it was fun. I thought it was cool at first. I didn't have an issue with it. You know what I mean? Because I just thought that it was not going to be a massive problem. Well, it turns out there's a gigantic U-turn that he had to hit right at the end of a hill. So he was probably hitting it around like 45 miles an hour, 35 to 45 miles an hour, even though those golf carts can only go to like 20 miles tops. So he clapped a U-turn. It started drifting and the golf cart flipped. I was on the golf cart. Austin was sitting next to me. We were facing the backside. Rambo was sitting in front of me facing forward. Next to Rambo was Jack Manifold, also facing forward on the left side. There was a Twitch staffer in the shotgun seat and also the driver. So when the golf cart flipped, I got injured. I was in shock. Like, I ran out of the golf cart immediately. I told Austin to get off me. And we picked up the golf cart because Rambo kept saying, like, my foot is stuck, my foot is stuck. We picked it up. It's whatever. There's no One Piece update. I haven't watched a single moment of One Piece. What the fuck, dude? I wasn't even at home. Am I okay? No, I'm not okay. I'm not okay at all. Because after that, after we got out, medics came. They rushed over. I had an injury. Like, it felt a little bad. But I was in shock still. But I could feel like a little discomfort on my left rib, like under my pec, okay? Around here. And it didn't feel great. So I told the medics that, and they were like, uh-oh, that's not good. We have to take you to the doctor. Austin was bleeding from his finger. I don't know how the fuck he like messed up his finger, really. I don't know how that even happened. But I mean, I also fucked up my arm a little bit. You can see the road rash a little bit. You can see the bruising here, but that's fine. That's like not the end of the world. My deltoid has like a little bit of bruising, but that part is fine. It didn't feel that bad, but I could tell, I could sense a little bit of discomfort in the beginning. When they took me to the doctor was like, he like, you know, touched around. He just like did a couple hits, taps, did a full checkup. Made an assessment and he said, yeah, you most likely broke your rib. It's not the end of the world. it's just really annoying. It's like one of those things where it's very annoying because the healing process, whether it's a fracture or a full break, is identical. It hurts to breathe. Like, it doesn't hurt that much right now. It's like a 2 when I'm just standing stable. But if I take a deep breath, it rockets up to like a 6 or a 7. Or depending on like what kind of moves I'm doing. Like when I move my arm a little bit, because I tried all the different things afterwards. You know, it's going to be a little bit difficult to work out, but I'll figure it out. It's just, it's a bitch when I actually cough. That's the worst part. Can't pick anything up. Can't do anything. Sneezing is also a terrifying prospect. Is this your first bone break? I guess technically it is, yeah. My kneecap, my bone, a piece of bone broke off my kneecap a while ago, but it was all right. So did it hurt more on the flight? No, actually I slept like a baby on the flight. And I legitimately think that I can't bench press, no. I can't do anything. I can't push. I can't do like push activities that much. And also, I've been hiding it very well. Most people don't even realize that there's something wrong. But yeah, after that, after the doctor, I was like, bro, give me something for the pain. And he was like, I'll give you whatever you want. And I was like, just give me like ibuprofen or whatever. So he gave me this shit. It just kept me alive. Gave me this. Doliprane. Paracetamol. This is what I've been fucking cracking every like 6 hours. Yeah, I smuggled that shit overseas into the US border, baby. I got that good stuff. It's probably illegal out here, you know what I'm saying? Any vlog content shot in Paris? No, man. No. I didn't shoot shit in fucking Paris. What the fuck? I'm literally explaining to you that I can't fucking move. And you're like, well, if you didn't stream, you might as well have shot vlog content. No, motherfucker, I didn't shoot vlog content. Okay? You want to know why? Because after my fucking rib broke, I did the meet and greet, and then I went back to my hotel room, and I slept the entire fucking time, and then I woke up, and I did my other obligation, the podcast, literally 5:30 p.m. After I was done with my first fucking day, 5:30 p.m., I went back to my hotel room. I passed the fuck out. I woke up. To someone knocking on the door because Twitch was like, oh, sorry for almost killing you. Here's like a bag of goodies, champagne and shit. Also, why the fuck would I even shoot vlogs? Austinox hasn't even uploaded the last year's TwitchCon vlog. We still have an England vlog. We still have a Japanese vlog, possibly 2 Japanese vlogs. So what the fuck am I doing? I'm not vlogging, okay? And I'm mad. I'm mad at you because now you're like, it's ridiculous. I don't know what happened to the driver. They probably fired him. I don't know. I didn't ask. Anyway, but yeah, I went to fucking sleep. So, that was a doctor bill? Like, there was no doctor bill. It's fucking France. There's no billing the doctor. But yeah, I couldn't stream because, like, I streamed a little bit after my meet and greet the first day, and it sucked. I'll be honest with you. It was just ass cheeks. I was in a fuck ton of pain. People kept coming up to me. I didn't want to show them that I was in pain. And I also, but I found myself, I caught myself being like very agitated. And it probably didn't look good on camera either. You know, and it was like such a weird hour. And most people don't give a fuck about my, like, you know, IRL streaming at all. So there was like 12K people watching on top of the camera overheating constantly because there was no fucking air conditioning. So it was like, it basically was like a mishmash of all of the worst possible things that could have happened. So I was like, I'm not doing it. I'm not going to stream for the rest of the time. Looks so old in the pictures. Oh, Jesus. Thanks, man. You can see in my face in every photo that we took. And I felt really bad about that. You know, I was just like, this sucks. The one thing I always tell you guys is that, you know, I'm in the position that I'm in, a tremendously fortunate position. Because of you guys, right? So I recognize that. That's something that I see, which is why I'll always take time, always make time to see the fans, right? But it obviously was, you know, I want to make sure that the time that I'm taking out for you guys is also good, pleasant experience for you. And I did feel like it wasn't necessarily all that pleasant if I'm just like disappointed, if I look just disappointed to see fans everywhere I go. You know, it was already like a lot of, it was just very painful to be walking around and lugging a camera. I just didn't, I was definitely more tired than I thought I was. So Did you get mad at the driver? Not really. I mean, it happens, dude. Whatever. I mean, his life is like probably more fucked up now. Are Rambo and Jack okay? Yes, they're fine. So anyway, that's my TwitchCon experience for the most part. Austin said y'all went shopping with Pogi though. We did for like a little bit. That's on Sunday. On Sunday, after I did the banter podcast, because I went to sleep at 5:30 Saturday and I literally woke up periodically in the night and there was no room service in the hotel. So I just ordered some Uber Eats and I ate the Uber Eats and I passed back. I passed the fuck out again. Woke up again in the morning, went and shot the banter podcast. It was significantly worse the second day, and it hasn't like gotten better necessarily. You know, hopefully it'll be better. Did you get some nice gifts while in Paris? No, not really. Would you travel back? Certainly. But the reason why I would travel back is that like now, if I go to France, I have someone that I can rely on. I have someone who I can hang out with. You know what I mean? Like I know a French person who lives in France. So it always makes the experience much better. Like even in Japan, having like locals that know the lay of the land makes your trip a lot more productive, both from a streaming standpoint, but also from like going to the best places. And then on Sunday after I was done with TwitchCon, because I pulled out of the IRL, I pulled out of Rivals because Rivals was like a physical competition. So I was like, I'm not doing that shit. Obviously, I can't even fucking move. I went shopping in like the vintage area of Paris, but it was all women's clothes. I went shopping with Pokey in Austin, but it was all women's clothes and it was all vintage and it was so fucking hot. And yeah, obviously that was early in the morning anyway in Paris. So it was, I wasn't going to stream that. And then after that, I went back to my hotel room, laid around a little bit more, and then we shot the Fear End podcast. So yeah, that's it.